Okay, today we're going to take a look at VLANs and how to set up a VLAN on our Switch. Both of our Switches, the setup is pretty much the same. In my case, I'm going to actually use our new PoE Switch today, just because I actually have one of the devices that we're going to be using is going to actually be using our access point. So we want to go through that access point to do it. Okay, now that we've got the interface up, it's a pretty darn simple thing to do. We're just going to go right here to VLAN. And it's going to pop up our VLAN mode. There's two different VLAN modes. We've got port-based VLAN and 802.1Q-based VLANs. The real difference is, in a port-based VLAN, it's basically just isolating ports from each other. There's not going to be any kind of tagging or anything else. Tagging actually takes place in the 802.1Q VLANs. So in our case, we're going to go ahead and show you the port-based VLANs first, and then we'll show you the 802.1Q-based VLANs. So in our port-based VLANs, we're going to go ahead and hop in here. And you'll notice that, for right now, every port is a member of VLAN 1. Well, what we want to do is we want to change that. We want only to have port 2 in VLAN 1. So we're going to go ahead and click Apply. That's going to move just port 2 into VLAN 1. But we want VLAN 2 to have port 1 as a member. So go ahead and click Apply again. And we'll notice that we've got that set up now. And now, all we're going to do to make sure that that's working is we're just going to take a look at a ping really quick. And we're going to go ahead and ping a device I know that is coming in through port 2, and that's 192.168.0.101. It's actually my phone connected to an access point. Okay, so now we've got our two devices. We've got them actually isolated out into their own VLANs. We're going to go ahead and just open up a command line. And we're going to go ahead and try to ping from my device, which is on port 1 in VLAN 2, to the device on port 2 in VLAN 1. We're just going to go 192.168.0.102, which is his current IP address. And as you can see, it's going to tell us that the destination host is unreachable. That's perfect. That's exactly what we want to see. Now, we'll say that, for instance, you do have this particular setup. We've got those two different VLANs, but we have port 8 is connected to our router, and we want to be able to get to the internet with our devices. So right now, if I try to get to the internet, I just spin, and nothing really happens. We're not going to be able to get to that. So what we actually have to do is we have to put that internet port link into the same VLAN that we're actually in. So we'll go for VLAN 1, we're going to do 2 and 8, click Apply. And then for VLAN 2, we're actually going to do port 1 and 8, and click Apply. You'll notice that port 8 shows up in two different VLANs. Oh no, was this still going to isolate our VLANs for us? Let's go take a look. So we're taking a look. We've still got the same device, the same address. We're going to go ahead and hit enter. And we're still blocked. But now, when we go to the internet, we've got internet access now. And we can actually get out there to the internet again. And the same will be true of our other device. Our other device will also be able to connect to the internet, but we still isolate those two devices and they don't see each other. And that's how we set up a port-based VLAN. So the next thing that we'll do is we'll go ahead and take a look at our 802.1Q VLAN. So we're going to go back to our VLAN mode, and this time we're going to go ahead and switch it and click Apply. So the config will be cleared for all other modes selected. That's okay. And now, this time, we actually go to the 802.1Q VLAN setup screen. Now, you'll notice that we have all ports in VLAN 1. This is the management VLAN. You cannot remove devices from this VLAN. That VLAN is there in the background for the management purposes. So actually, what we have to do is we have to create two new VLANs. So we'll create VLAN 2. And for this one, we'll say we want ports 1 and 8 as members. We're going to go ahead and click Apply. Notice we've got 1 and 8. Now, we want to create VLAN 3. And we're going to do the same thing, but this time it's going to be ports 2 and 8. We'll click apply. Same rules apply here. So what we have to do, they have to be separate. They have to have that common connection to the internet, or the internet will be blocked for them, just like we showed you with the port beast. But let's take a look here real quick. If we try to ping them, we're good. We're still isolated. Everything works. So it's exactly the way that we really want to see that. We're isolating the traffic between those two client devices. It's blocking that traffic. And let's go see if we've still got our internet access. We do. So we're good to go. We're still connected. And VLANs are great for systems, especially where you're using a lot of different systems that are latency sensitive, like VoIP, video streaming, music streaming, anything like that. What you can do is you can put that music server and then all of the other devices that may play that music on one VLAN. Or you can put your phone server and all of your phones on another VLAN. And that keeps those VLANs separate so that they're not fighting for priority with those other devices in your network. Like I say, it's an awesome way to keep things isolated so that you can have a particular system set up maybe for guest access, where you might have guests that come into your home. You want them to have internet access, but maybe you don't want them to be able to get into your media server or your home control server, something of that nature. This is also a great way to keep those networks separate and keep them secure. But that's VLANs. It's the same for both of our managed switches, whether you're using the 24-port managed switch or our PoE switch, which we happen to be actually using for the example today.